I'm Loretta DiPietro, and I'm the course director for this particular course, The Biological Basis of Disease in Public Health. This is a very exciting time. With regard to this course, we've just revitalized and reorganized it. And so what we've done is split the course into three parts. In the first part, we will cover what we term the fundamentals of disease processes, and we'll discuss some cell biology and physiology. We'll discuss the concept of homeostasis and how homeostasis in human functioning is disrupted by external factors that human beings have to contend with on a daily basis. We'll discuss some of the very beginnings of disease process, like inflammation, neoplasia, etc. In the second part of the course, we then start to apply those fundamentals to real public health issues, first in developed countries. As you know, most of our public health burden in the United States and Europe is assumed by lifestyle-related behaviors. And so we'll cover certain selected lifestyle diseases, such as cardiometabolic diseases, cancer, etc. And we'll cover those diseases across the biological spectrum, meaning you'll be applying the basic fundamentals. But then we work across to the applied systems level and then to the population level. So each week we'll cover particular diseases across the biological and across the public health spectrum. The final part of the course, we will cover diseases or exposures having particular public health relevance to developing countries. So topics are issues like HIV, AIDS, malaria, disease resistance, topics such as that. And once again, we'll cover these topics from the cellular all the way to the whole body population level. And across the public health spectrum. So what you're going to have in this course, and I might point out it's very different than other courses of this nature, is you'll have the opportunity to learn the fundamental, the biological underpinnings of disease processes, and you'll be able to apply them across the public health spectrum. Many of you come to the table perhaps already trained as biologists or physiologists, but we recognize that many people coming into public health might be population-based scientists, might be policymakers, regulators, administrators, etc. We feel it's very important that you have at least a basic understanding of the biological mechanisms and underpinnings that inform your work. It will make you a better public health scientist and a better public health practitioner. So welcome to the course, and I look forward to working with you.